I am so sick and tired of the term OLED killer. It's been beat to death and it's pretty much just clickbait now, right? I think I've only applied that term once to a TV, at least recently, and even then more as a question to stoke a discussion. But guys, I think I have actually found a real potential OLED killer, and Sony showed it to me. I'm about to drop a bomb for you, so sit tight, because I think y'all are gonna love this. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Caleb Dennison, and let's just dive right into it. So I recently got back from a trip to visit Sony in Tokyo, where it showed me something I have never seen before. Turns out, Sony has been working on RGB Mini-LED for 3 years now. I got to see it, and I'm here to tell you that if ever there was going to be an OLED killer, at least in the premium TV space, this is it. Now, if you're watching this and a little unclear on what RGB Mini-LED is, or if you're already screaming at your screen, "But Caleb, didn't Hisense already announce this?" Well, let me catch you up and tell you why what I'm talking about today is different and important. Now, I'm gonna have to lean a little on an assumption that you have an understanding of what's so great about Mini-LED TVs already, at least a little. If you don't, here's a Mini-LED explainer that you can go watch. But I'm gonna encapsulate it here anyway so you don't feel like you have to jump away and come back. I think you're gonna get it. Mini-LED TVs improved on regular LED TVs by shrinking down the size of the LED backlight. See, LED and Mini-LED TVs all use LCD panels, and they always have. But the big improvements we've seen to LCD TVs have been to the backlight technology, stuff like processing and dimming zones and brightness power. So we just started calling LCD TVs LED TVs, and now that Mini-LED is out, we're calling them Mini-LED TVs. By making the LED backlights super tiny, TV makers have been able to cram more of them in a smaller amount of space and have been able to break down the grid of backlights into more numerous and smaller zones. The advantage, in most cases at least, has been higher brightness, better black levels, better contrast, which is what we love to see when looking at a TV, and better efficiency. All of that with less of the stuff that bugged us with regular LED TVs, like blooming and halo and obvious backlight transitions. Stuff that takes us out of the immersion that we enjoy when watching a movie, right? One of the cool things about Mini-LED is that it didn't cost a ton to start making it. Existing production lines could be used to make the TV, since the only thing that really changed was the backlight and the processing, the brains behind the operation. That allowed Mini-LEDs to come down in price pretty quickly, and that basically democratized premium picture quality. Lots of reasons to love Mini-LED, right? But Mini-LED, just like regular LED, has always had a weakness: the color of the Mini-LED light. See, the way LCD TVs have always worked is that you wanna shine a white light through a color filter. The more pure that white light is, the easier it is for the color filter to do its job and give you a beautiful picture. But getting pure white light from an LED is hard, too hard. So what TV makers did was settle on using blue LEDs, or blue Mini-LEDs, shine those on red and green quantum dots, and the combo gave us a very nicely pure white light. We call these TVs QLEDs. The Q stands for quantum dots. And they work great, but here's the problem with using a white backlight. That white light is easily visible when it leaks through an LCD panel. That's what causes milky or gray blacks. It's what puts halos around bright objects on a dark background. It's what makes getting shadow details in otherwise pitch black scenes kind of hard to pull off. And because the color filter has to work so hard, it was hard to get expanded color gamut and color brightness, which, well, our eyes love colors too, and they definitely enjoy sparkling brightness. Now, this new RGB Mini-LED addresses those lingering problems by eliminating the reliance on blue LEDs alone, and thus the white light that comes from them through their partnership with quantum dots. So forget the white light stuff. Now we have a backlight making independent red, green, and blue colors. And we get a couple of benefits there. For one, backlight bleeding, blooming, halo, all that stuff is going to be reduced. When it does leak, it's gonna be harder for us to see it. we're gonna be drawn more to the picture we see than the backlight that's helping to make it. It also lightens the load on the LCD panel's color filter. The less work the color filter has to do, the more brightness can actually shine through. And that's where Sony's flavor of RGB Mini-LED technology comes in. Sony has been diligently working on this tech for 3 years already. And with today's announcement, we now know that they are going to be starting mass production of these RGB Mini-LED displays this year, 2025. That means we're probably looking at RGB Mini-LED TVs from Sony in 2026. And when that happens, well, I think that's when the OLED TV story starts to shift. I know a lot of enthusiasts have been wondering what a Bravia 10 might look like. And I'm just guessing here, I could end up being wrong, but I'm betting a Bravia 10 would be an RGB Mini-LED TV, and I could not be more excited by that idea. But hold on a second, why am I waving around the OLED killer term now when I've been so reluctant to do it in the past? And why am I talking so much about Sony's RGB Mini-LED right now without also talking about the RGB Mini-LED that Hisense has already announced and will probably come to market with this very year? But let's talk about the OLED killer thing first. The only TV technology that could beat back OLED, in my opinion, was one that got black levels, white brightness, and color brightness, and color purity slash color gamut right up to OLED levels, or at least perceptually up to OLED levels. And it's gonna need to have like awesome off-angle viewing too, an area that OLED has basically dominated year after year. But it isn't just about picture quality. The real OLED killer will do all of that stuff in a wide range of sizes, including up to 98 or 100 inches, and do it for less than OLED. And I think that Sony's RGB Mini-LED tech can do all of that. I think it's gonna be able to punch up well beyond the 77-inch screen size without spinning into super expensive pricing territory. Will they be expensive? Yes, it's a premium TV technology, but expensive relative to OLED at that size? I don't think so. So, you provide picture quality that rivals OLED in all the ways that matter while also costing less? That is the magic formula. But to that second question, why am I giving props to Sony right now? Why haven't I brought Hisense into the conversation yet? Well, let's bring Hisense into it now. Hisense is gonna be first. Hisense will lay claim to having the first RGB Mini-LED TV on the market. When its 116-inch monster TV starts hitting showrooms and home theaters and maybe even some living rooms, it's probably gonna get showered with praise. I've seen a prototype of that TV in action, albeit very briefly, at CES, and it is definitely super impressive. But I also noticed a few issues that have me concerned. See, here's the thing. What we haven't talked about enough so far is how hard it is to make RGB Mini-LED backlighting work well. Here's an example. Let's say you have a big yellow flower on the screen, and right next to that yellow flower are bright green leaves. And both the yellow flower and the green leaves are serviced by the same backlight zone. Now you have some serious decisions to make, and you're gonna have to make them fast. You've got red, green, and blue primary colors to work with as a light source, and you have a color filter to work with too. So what do? Do you make the backlight yellow and use color filtering to get the green for the leaves? Or do you flip that around and make a green backlight and use color filtering to get the yellow for the flower? You have to do one or the other. Which one's gonna be more efficient? And how do you make that decision in real time? Here's where Sony comes in. I was able to talk to Sony's engineers and I posited this same question to them right then and there. And while they didn't give me the magic recipe, and of course they wouldn't, they did say that's what they've been working on for 3 years or more and why they won't be coming out with this tech until 2026. Because they aren't interested in being first, they just want to be the best. Sound familiar? Apple. Turns out the processing needed to do this, as I suspected, is really tricky and very hard to pull off. You're talking about coordinating additive color mixing with one hand and subtractive color making with the other. You basically took what was already a really hard job and made it a whole lot harder. But I think if anyone has the processing chops to do it, it's Sony. More to the point, I got to see Sony's prototype doing this exact thing. Yellow flowers and green leaves handled by a backlight showing just one color. Sony's processing works. I've seen it in action and it works really, really well. So well that I was simply blown away by the RGB Mini-LED TV that it ended up showing me. Unfortunately, I wasn't allowed to shoot video at this event. Nobody was, at least not on the record, so I can't show you exactly what I saw. We're including all the assets in this video that Sony would allow. But you don't have to take my word for it. Lots of other respected journalists and content creators saw it too, and I think they're gonna be providing similarly rave reviews and experiences. Now, all this isn't to say that I don't think Hisense has the processing needed to pull off RGB Mini-LED. Clearly, Hisense does have it. They've gotten really aggressive with their processing lately. I just don't know how well it's gonna work compared to what I saw from Sony at such a deep level. I hope to learn more when I visit Hisense soon, but I'm not gonna be able to fully test the TV when I do visit them, so I'm not sure what I'm going to learn yet. I do promise to tell you exactly what I learned though, so subscribe now, that way you're not gonna miss out. But beyond how well Hisense's processing will work, I don't know how Hisense's timetable for scaling this RGB Mini-LED TV tech down to normal size TVs is gonna be. I know we can expect some smaller sizes of RGB Mini-LED from Hisense in 2026 because that's just how Hisense operates. They're gonna be super competitive. The only question is, how small? Can we expect a 65-inch RGB Mini-LED from Hisense? I think that we might get that from Sony next year. Well, maybe now we can expect that from Hisense. Regardless, by the time that happens, Sony will be competing directly with Hisense on RGB Mini-LED tech. So I guess what I'm saying here is the race is on. We already have something super exciting to look forward to in 2026 with a giant-sized appetizer coming in 2025, courtesy of Hisense. Now it's just a matter of seeing how things shake out. And I'd be surprised if at least one other brand didn't toss its name into the RGB Mini-LED ring as well. Regardless, I think that OLED has a real challenger now in the premium TV space. I don't doubt OLED's gonna continue to win award after award for years to come, but I also don't think OLED will be the slam dunk winner for best TV tech that it once was. And hey, that is a good thing. This kind of technological progress is what we need to stoke competition, because when brands compete, consumers win. And I think that's what has me so excited about RGB Mini-LED. And thanks to Sony for giving me the deep inside look that I needed to understand exactly why it's such a game changer and how. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. What do you think? Let me know down in the comments. You got any concerns? Are you excited? Let me know down there. Don't forget to like this video, click that little thumbs up button. Subscribe if you want to see more, because I've got a whole lot more like this. I'll see you on the next one. And until then, here's two other videos I think you might like. Turns out Sony has been working on dust.